you so much for joining us tonight for this hopefully very calming and gentle and relaxing hair play video. And in this video I will be using various brushes and tools and just making Vicky feel nice and comfortable. So I hope you enjoy. So I'm first going to start with this beautiful paddle brush. And I'll take a moment to run it through the ends of the hair first. Obviously, with Vicky's hair being so long, I don't want to run it through the whole lengths to start with, because I don't want to hurt her or snag any knots. And I've placed her hair over her back so she can feel the beautiful wooden bristles over her shoulder. I'm just going to make sure to pay some attention to the nape of the neck and the bottom of the scalp in this session, because I feel it can be neglected sometimes, and for me the nape of the neck is the most tingliest part. I'm just following along with my hand, gently grazing my fingertips over the scalp as well. Okay, so I'm actually going to move on to use a comb now. And again, it's a very pretty wooden comb. And I'm just taking that and working my way from the outside of Vicky's hairline through the hair. I love the sound in which wooden comb makes through the hair. I just think it's very pretty. And also the way that different combs can separate the hair. So again, I'm just gently running the comb through the length of the hair. And I do like to use a wooden comb to scratch over the scalp as well, because that can feel really pleasant too. So I'm just gently scratching down the scalp and then running the comb through her beautiful hair. Vicky has the softest hair imaginable. It's so pretty. And I love to play with it, so so it always makes me happy when she comes round to film a hair play session. So I'm now just taking her hair in my hand and stretching it out to run the comb all the way through. So I've just grabbed another similar wooden comb that I have, and I wanted to just run both combs through the hair at the same time. I think this can also feel really, really nice on the scalp. And it's good for blood circulation as well. And also the sound is just really nice too. Move on and use this really cute back scratching tool I have, and I'll start with gliding it over her back and up her neck and into her hair. And again, it's a different kind of sound because it's a metal tool, but I do enjoy using this mini scratching tool because again, it feels very pleasant on the back and the neck and the scalp. It's such a satisfying sensation when you gently scratch over the scalp, I think. So I'm just taking little wispy baby hairs and placing them over her neck. Would you enjoy this kind of treatment? Would it send you off to sleep, or would it just be a bit too stimulating for you? Or are you a bit ticklish? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this treatment. So I have this beautiful fluffy makeup brush, and I'll begin with tracing it over her back and down her arms, being very, very gentle. And then I'm going to take the brush and start to gently stroke of her neck whilst playing with her hair at the same time. And I'll begin to trace over her ear very softly, making sure not to disturb her beautiful piercings. All the while still playing with her hair. Again, this is something that I could have done to me for hours. I find it so relaxing and comforting. So I'll continue to trace up the neck and into the hairline. I now have two brushes here, and one is a soft bristle brush and one is a more dense style brush. And again, I'm going to use them together, just gently running them through the hair. And the reason I wanted to have two different brushes is because I thought it would have two different sensations on the scalp, so that might feel quite nice for Vicky. And also it has two very different sounds that they make when they run over the scalp and through her hair. So I'm going to use both the brushes and almost trap some of her beautiful hair between them and just tug at the hair a little bit. Brushing up the nape of the neck. Okay, so we're going to move on to a comb again, and I have this very long toothed comb which I love to use on the scalp. It feels so nice. So I'm just going to take a moment and run that up the back, across the neck and into the gently tease little bits of hair away from the scalp. ends of the hair for a moment just to get any of those little knots out. Look at how beautiful her hair is. It's like a waterfall of hair. Exfoliating brushes, and again I just thought it would be a nice different sensation to use these over the skin and the scalp and through the hair. I'll just gently use them to massage around the ear area and also on the back. Find that they make really nice noise on fabric as well, so we'll just do that for a moment. And again, I'm just gliding them over the hairline and into the hair. And I'll use them both to again trap little pieces of hair within them. Just tease them away from the scalp. Just around the hairline, the baby hairs. Okay, so I've quickly grabbed the oval bristle brush again, and I just want to take a moment to use that on its own. On the nape of the neck at the moment. I feel that Vicky is very relaxed right now, so I'm just going that little bit slower over the hair. Gentle scratching of the scalp using my fingernails and my fingertips. Just gliding them over the scalp and through her hair very gently. And I'll give it a gentle scratch as well. I sometimes feel that there's nothing better than having actual physical hands on the scalp, like scalp massages and things like that. But I do also enjoy nice gentle scratching of the scalp as well. Vicky may have gone to sleep now, so I actually feel a little bit bad that I have to wake her up in a moment. But we have come to the end of this video, and just as Vicky will be waking up, hopefully you will be going off to sleep. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please like, comment and subscribe, and I'll see you again soon. Bye!